Ask Reddit by Lolotmj. What software will become outdated shut down in the next couple of years? The software in your smart TV is about to get real slow. My LG had an update a month or so ago that completely bricked it. Won't even turn on anymore. It had one a few weeks earlier that made it extremely slow and make the apps turn off after a few minutes. When I looked up how to set it back to factory defaults for my specific model, I found a guide to do so but then also found out that at some point another update removed the option to actually reset it. On one hand, I get the company fucking with things to make you buy a new one, but it would never work like that because no, I will 110% never under any circumstance buy anything at all that's LG again. Not sure, but 99% probability it's a Google product people actually enjoy. Google search as we know it 10 blow links will be replaced by a conversational report from multiple sources. Here is a positive one. TurboTax. Hopefully the IRS makes its own free online tax filing software available to everyone, and TurboTax and HR Block software can die an ignominious death. Free Tax USA is by far the best service available right now if you have relatively simple taxes. Cobble? Just kidding. Bro, I swear to God, the day humanity goes extinct is because we no longer have the people to maintain Cobble codes at nuclear missile silos. Intuit's Mint. RIP. I loved it for years. Then its updating stopped working reliably. Then it took a large asset and started recording it as a debt, completely messing up all reports. Talked to support, they couldn't fix it, AOI stopped using it. I'm in backup and recovery sales, on-prem, legacy software. We do operate in the multi-cloud now, but we are not cloud native and we are hemorrhaging big time to cloud-based backups. Even the federal government, who stays on old solutions longer to be safe, is starting to make the move. Don't think the industry will ever totally die, but the golden age is for sure dead. It'll always have a spot. Some stuff shouldn't be cloud backed up. Most streaming services, digital media emo. Netflix was such a hit that everyone and their grandma made a streaming service, but now there are so many and nobody wants to pay for each one individually. I think as people start to get sick and tired of paying $10.99 each for Netflix, Hulu, Apple TV, Paramount Plus, Disney Plus, Discovery Plus, insert cabbage channel number here, Plus, etc. sometimes with ads, they'll cut back to one or two with the best content. Most of them are in serious debt too, because they're all spending stupid amounts of money for shitty projects just in the hope that they'll get the next big thing. Sooner or later the house is going to come crashing down and only a few will survive. The cynic in me says that as they go down, a lot of content will end up in Sony's or Disney's vault, never to see the light of day again. I'm so disappointed in this too. Netflix was the reason for a massive drop in piracy. Also, they've been a real boon to the open source community. Tons of really awesome repos came out of Netflix. For those of us in healthcare, I fervently wish to hear that Meditech and HCA have been wiped from existence. Mayo didn't expect to see Meditech mentioned on Ask Reddit ever. Everything bought by Oracle. They buy stuff and let it rot so it doesn't become competition. They lose money on the product, but ultimately it's worth it for them just so they can't compete. I believe Oracle, as Cerner, are about to become the biggest loser in the healthcare space. Epic is everywhere, eating their lunch. When some important dependencies fail because lack of fund, expect internet shutdown. https://xkcd.com/2347/. When the guy who maintains Image Magic retires, we're screwed. Be Real is done for. It was a flash in the pan for teens and people in their early 20s. It's a feature that was easily copied into other apps and really serves no purpose other than that. I thought the same thing about Snapchat, but they've managed to endure. Windows 10 is ending support soon, probably within a couple years. Windows 8.1 just had its support end this year. Windows 8 had its support ended in 2018. We've got until 2028 most likely before support ends. Now that is extended security support, 2026 for features and bug fixes. Third-party tax software. Hopefully. A lot of hospitals still have some software from the 80s. Seriously. I had MC my screen and ask if I was using DOS in 2019. All of Canada still uses faxes because of some nonsense about email not being secure or owned by the patient. Macromedia Flash. It still exists. McAfee. Antivirus companies somehow convinced people to pay them a lot of money for a product that barely does anything and is actively harmful. They can't go out of business, their business model is just too good. Old versions of 32-bit Windows are going to actually have what the Y2K bug was supposed to be in 2038. Cerner. Electronic health record that is failing to keep up. I hope it's any subscription-based service. Me too, but unfortunately I think more will eventually go this route. I genuinely hope with all my heart that algorithm-driven social platforms will all collapse soon. Instagram, Facebook, TikTok, Twitter, they're just sort of ruining everyone's lives in a lot of ways, and I feel there's a slim possibility that at some point people will start to clock on and find a better way to do things. Realistically though, it's going to take either A, a better alternative, and or B, government intervention making it near impossible for these platforms to function. Preach it. I crave 2010 internet every day of my life. A lot less than you expect. We have code that we still run and maintain that was developed internally in 2002 still going strong. I think this is the real answer. Back in the day, Google had the cleanest searches. When they still had "Don't be evil" as a motto. Now Google searches are shit. I just won't use it anymore. Any Chromium-based search gives the same bullshit results with same bullshit ad and sponsored links. What do you recommend instead? On behalf of all it guys everywhere, I pray SAP will shut down. As an operations specialist in manufacturing, I am sorry to disappoint. SAP isn't going anywhere. There is no viable alternative on the market for large-scale international companies. ChatGPT. It's the first one of those to blow up, but usually the trailblazer gets surpassed. I think it's going to get bundled into someone else's ecosystem, so if you want to use it, you'll have to either give away all your data or pay a monthly fee. From recent events, you'll probably have to at least sign up for an Outlook email account to use it in the next couple of years. You won't believe it, but I fear that Microsoft Paint may soon become obsolete. Paint has had more active development than it's seen in decades. I guess the question is, what counts as MS Paint? MS Paint as a Windows 3.1 pixel editing tool from the 80s is already dead. But I think MS Paint is more relevant and useful than ever. https://www.microsoft.com/en-us/windows/paint. I fear for the day children genuinely ask what a CD is. Next to go is probably wire chargers, since most devices would be touch charged. In as crazy as it sounds, Snapchat. I give it 5 years. Still very popular for people who do casual hookups. There's also more people who get Snapchat Plus than you might think. I personally barely use it, but it still has a very active user base. Grammarly, I will say. Facebook, Instagram and Europe. All these privacy laws will force Meta's hand. They've already started to ask users to agree to personalized ads to continue to use their apps or pay to use them without ads, and the EU is currently trying to ban it. I hope to God it will be SAP. Please, can someone else come up with a more intuitive interface? Please let it be Jira. Threads. X. Don't forget, formerly known as Twitter. At home DVD Blu-ray authoring, unfortunately. I hope it's Oracle and I hope it's tomorrow. It sucks ass. Meow, you will replace me.